Hi, and welcome to this introduction to Pro-Q 3, the latest stage in the evolution of FabFilter's famous EQ plugin. Pro-Q 3 adds some major new features, such as dynamic EQ. Refinements to existing features, such as frequency tooltips when using spectrum grab. And per-band stereo channel selection. And it can now go beyond stereo with support for surround formats up to 712 Dolby Atmos. However, the FabFilter team have been careful to preserve the most important features of earlier releases. The interface is carefully designed to be ergonomic and intuitive, as well as attractive, so you can work quickly and efficiently. You can drag in bands and set the cue with your mouse wheel. Double-click to place bands where you want them. Drag from the left or right to create shelving bands. Or double-click to the left or right to add low or high cut filters. And you can select multiple bands to tweak them together. You can also solo bands to listen to those frequencies in isolation. You can use spectrum grab to find and fix problem resonances. Or you can use the EQ match features to automatically create corrective EQ curves. But these advanced features never get in the way of the core EQ functionality. And behind the scenes, Pro-Q 3 is tightly coded and highly optimized, so it can still be the go-to EQ that you load onto every channel of your mix, just like its predecessors. Let's start with a new analyzer feature. As with Pro-Q 2, you can superimpose the sidechain spectrum on top of the input spectrum and view them both together. Pro-Q 3 goes a step further and allows you to pick any other instance of Pro-Q 3 instead and compare this to the signal you're EQing. Each instance is named after the track it's loaded on, with a mini spectrum display to help you identify them. But you can rename each instance manually if required. And I can now view the spectrum of the bass part while EQing the kick drum, for example, with subtle red shading to indicate areas that are prominent in both parts. Pro-Q 3 has always been able to do mid-side EQ, but Pro-Q 3 now allows you to set this per band, so you can EQ the mid or the side with one band, while other bands in the same instance can be set to just the left or right channel. Of course, the channel options are more complex when working in surround formats. Pro-Q 3 provides an intuitive graphic, which makes it easy to switch between all channels apart from the sub, or all channels including sub, or individual channels or pairs of channels. This setup also allows you to target just the left or right channel within a stereo pair, or more advanced options such as mid or side for a specific stereo pair, or for all stereo pairs. All bands have a choice of slope settings right up to 96 dB per octave. But low and high cut filters can now go even steeper with the new brick wall filters. These sound remarkably natural considering the extreme slopes, making them useful for sound design or complex surgery. By contrast, the new flat tilt is super gentle and transparent, allowing you to add brightness or warmth without changing the basic character of the sound at all. But probably the most exciting new feature is the dynamics. All the gain knobs now have a ring around them to set the range. If I turn it down, this low shelving band is now compressing the low frequencies as well as boosting them. Dynamic bands gain a range handle on the graph, above or below the usual band node, which we can drag up or down to adjust the range. Let's drag in a high shelf from the right and dial in some compression for the high frequencies as well. I'll also add a bell-shaped band in the lower mids to help clear congestion, but this time with some upward expansion to avoid losing the warmth. The dynamics algorithm is carefully designed to be a fluid extension of the main EQ functions, so attack, release and threshold are set automatically, and all you need to do is dial in the range. The clever FabFilter algorithms under the hood ensure that in most cases it will just work without fuss and do exactly what you want. Sometimes you need to be more surgical, however, like when targeting sibilants, for example. In which case you can switch to a fixed threshold and adjust it with the slider to the right, so you can specify exactly when the dynamic behaviour kicks in. Over to the left we have buttons to clear dynamic behaviour, or to disable the dynamics so you can compare with the static version. Alternatively, you can use the band menu to enable or disable dynamics, or to change the shape, slope, or stereo placement, or even to invert gains, which also inverts any dynamic behavior for the selected band. Notice that enabling dynamics doesn't change any of the other characteristics of the EQ. The shapes remain true to the analog models, with no cramping near Nyquist. And we can still choose from slope settings all the way up to 96 dB per octave. We can still set different channels for each band, so I could set the lower bands to process just the mid channel, and split the higher bands to create independent bands for left and right channels, and also independent dynamic behavior. You can even enable dynamics for the tilt filter, or for the new flat tilt filter, and simultaneously compress the low end while expanding the highs, or vice versa. And it will all work fine in natural phase and linear phase modes, as well as zero latency. As before, you can choose from a range of different interface sizes, or you can run full screen mode. You can access the manual via the help menu, or you can enable context-sensitive help hints when you hover over a control. That's all for now. Thanks for watching.